Okay, hi. So now let's continue with our second lecture for chapter 5, Mathematics of Finance, with our subtopic 5.2, Simple Discount. Okay, so please take a look at this word discount. Okay, do you think it's the same discount as the sales discount at the shopping mall, Padini, or is it the same? No, we are talking about bank discount. Okay, that is a totally different concept from sales discount. So now let's take a look at our learning objective. Okay guys, let's look at our learning objective that we have. Number one, at the end of this lecture, you should able to find simple discount. Okay. Simple discount here is notated by capital D. Okay, capital D. And proceed. You will learn what is proceed, what is simple discount. Okay, our capital D and our proceed. Okay, number two, our learning objective will be you should able to find the equivalent simple interest rate to simple discount rate. Okay, which is this our formula. Alright, and our last learning objective for today's lecture is you should able to solve problems involving finding proceed, time, amount, and simple discount rate. So this one I think is small d. Okay. If simple discount, it is capital D. For simple discount rate is our R. Okay. So let's continue to our next part for this lecture. Okay, so now let's take a look about simple discount. What is it? Alright guys, simple discount is the amount that bank deducts from a loan in advance. Okay, so it means discount is not what you get, but what bank get. Okay, the amount that the borrower receive after the deduction is called as proceed. Alright, it's called as proceed. So, in a simple discount, the amount borrowed before deducting the charge is the future value. This is S, this is D, this is proceed. Simple discount is also known as bank discount. So it's just the same name, the same meaning. Okay, if you didn't get, let I make an example here. Okay, let's say this is you. Okay, and we have a bank here. Alright, this is bank B. Alright, you want to make loan with bank if 5k. Okay, you nak buat loan from bank 5k, but bank only give you 4.5k. okay, your 5k here is your S, total loan. Your 4.k here is your proceed. Okay, so how much did the discount that bank take? It is 0.5k. this is your D. Okay, that is your capital D, right? So that is what we are talking about right now. So let's go further to our content here. Let's see the formula. Okay, for you to find your proceed, okay, how much the money that you get after you apply the loan is actually the loan that you do, the loan that you make minus the bank discount D. Okay, how you can calculate D? For you to calculate D is take your total loan multiply with discount rate multiply with how long you make the loan. Okay, the time in years. So D is equal to SDT. So we substitute inside here. You can also use another formula, which is proceed is equal to S minus SDT, or just factor S bracket 1 minus DT. Okay, So let's take a look at the units for each term. We have time in years, of course, met finance, all time in years. There's no month, there is no seconds, okay? There's no hour as well. Must be in years. Okay, D. Small d is our simple discount rate in percentage. Okay? That's different from our capital D. Capital D is our simple discount or bank discount. Actually, D is what bank deducts ataupun or bank takes from your loan. Okay? The bank charge you for the loan. Okay? So, who got the money? Bank. Okay? Your S is the amount of loan and your proceeds is what you get as borrower. Okay? So, all these three is in RM because it is money. Okay? Alright, let's look at this example for our bank discount or simple discount. Abdul Halim borrowed RM25,000 for 90 days and he was charged a bank discount rate 6/1/2% per year. What is the bank's discount and Abdul Halim proceeds? So let's take out all the information that we have. Borrowed means your S. So your S is 25,000. Here your T is in days, so we change into years. Okay, so as we look here, it doesn't mention anything about years. So let's take our ordinary years, which is 360. Okay, ordinary. If it has the word exact or leap year, so we will use 365 or 366. Okay, he was charged a bank discount rate. So here is your D is equal to 6/1/2 is 6.5%. And we just change it. We will change it into decimal places. So divide it is 0.065. What is the bank discount? Bank discount, remember, it's not discount that you get, it's the value that bank get. Okay, so our D is equal to, we want to find your D here, SDT. Okay, the multiplication of all them, let's put the value 0.065. T is 90/360. Okay, so your bank discount, the value that bank will get from Abdul Halim, okay, the value that bank charge Abdul Halim is RM400.25. Okay, next, we want to find the proceed. Okay, so here is your proceed. Proceed is equal to your total loan divided by D. Okay, the total loan that you make. Okay, so your total loan is 25,000 minus your 406.25. Okay, so how much is it? It will be 24,593.75. Okay, so that's mean. So if you understand here, this is what bank charge. Okay, this is loan that you make and this is the only money, all right, that you got. Okay, all right, so that's the case for Abdul Halim. So let's proceed with our next example. We have Asma borrowed, okay, we charge bank discount rate. So this is your D. Okay. This is your D. If the proceed is received. Okay. So here, dia dah bagi tahu this is proceed. Of the period of 9 months. Okay. Months. Kita mesti tukar. In terms of years. Find the value of discount charge. Discount charge here is we want to find the value of D. Okay, let's take all information that we have. We have D equal to 12%. So let's change to our decimal places. 12% means 12/100. So it's 0.12. Proceed is 3, 5, 6, 8. T is 9 months. That means you need to change into years. So we have 12 months. So 9 over 12. We want to find the value of D. Right. Okay. So here, our formula, we have D equal to S dt. Okay, but if you want to use the formula, you don't have your S. Okay, and you didn't use your proceeds. So let's look at another formula. We know that proceed is equal to S 1 minus dt. This is one of our formula. Okay, again, we don't know S, but you have your proceed, you have your D, you have T, so we can find S first. So let's substitute the value. We have 3, 5, 6, 8 equal to S 1 minus 0.129 over 12. So our S, the total loan that Asma made with the OCBC, which is RM 352.88. Okay. Alright. But we didn't want S. We want our D. So D S DT. You already have your S. We multiply with our D, 0.12. Multiply with time is 9 over 12. So your discount charge. Okay, the value that bank got from the loan that you apply, Asma apply, is RM352.88. Okay, look at here, class. Okay, look at here. You must put in two decimal places because it is RM. You must have, it is compulsory to put two decimal places. Okay. So let's go to a next example. Jailani borrowed, okay, 45,000. That means his loan, right? So here is your S. For 3 years, okay, 3 years is your time. Okay, here is your T. From government bank. If the bank discount rate is 7.6% per year, what proceed does Jailani receive? Okay, so if you understand well the sentence, you understand for each term, let's take out. Alright, T is 3 years, D is 0.076. Okay, and so we want to find proceed. Okay, so which formula that's suitable for us to use? The answer here is proceed, we know, is equal to S multiplied with 1 minus dt. Okay, so it's perfect with the value that you already have, 45,000. 1 minus 0.076 multiplied with t, 3 years. Okay, let's calculate on your calculator how much you get. Please remember proceed in RM. RM 34,740. Okay, this is what Jailani get from the bank. So you can see here what is your D. You can take your 45k minus your proceed. Okay, so this is easy.